Namaste. Welcome to the lecture on Prim's algorithm. The working of the Prim's algorithm is explained here. The Prim's algorithm uses greedy method. It starts with a single arbitrary vertex. Then it expands the vertex as a tree by selecting adjacent edge with minimum weight. Informally, the algorithm can be described as follows. Initialize a tree with a single vertex chosen arbitrarily from the graph. Then, grow the tree by one edge. The strategy that is used to select the edge is as follows. Among the edges that connect the tree to vertices not yet in the tree, find the minimum weight edge and add to the tree. Repeat step 2 until all the vertices are in the tree. Suppose if we have n vertices in the tree, we need to repeat step 2 n minus 1 number of times, as minimum spanning tree contains n minus 1 number of edges. Let us take an example to know the working of the Prim's algorithm. Consider a graph with 6 nodes with different weights for the edges. Let us consider A as a starting vertex. The vertex A has 3 adjacent edges, AB, AD and AF. The weights are 2, 5 and 6. Among 2, 5 and 6, select the minimum that corresponds to AB. So select the edge AB. In the next iteration, select the edges that are adjacent to this A and B that doesn't form the cycle. Here we can see the edges with weight 8, 6, 5 and 6. 5 is the minimum, select the edge. In the next iteration, consider the edges with weights 8, 3, 7, 6 and 6. Please note the edge with BD is avoided because it will lead to the cycle. So among these adjacent edges, select the one DC that is having the minimum weight. Similarly, consider the next adjacent edges that are nothing but B, that are nothing but CE, DE, AF and DF. These weights are 5, 6, 7 and 6. Choose the one with the minimum weight, that is nothing but 5. Similarly, the last vertex that is remaining is F. The edges need to be considered are AF, DF and EF. Choose the one that is EF with the minimum weight. Now we obtained a spanning tree that consists of 5 edges. The Prim's algorithm can be stated as follows. The input for this algorithm is the weighted connected graph G. G is represented as a set of vertices and set of edges. The output of this particular algorithm is minimum spanning tree represented by ET. ET is a set of edges composing a minimum spanning tree of G. As we already know, we need to start with one vertex which is arbitrarily selected. Let V0 be the vertex which is selected arbitrarily. VT represents a set of tree vertices can be initialized with any vertex. Initialize the set of edges of the tree as null. for I is equal to 1 to number of vertices minus 1 do. So this is a for loop which will be iterated n minus 1 number of times. N is nothing but the number of vertices in the tree. At each iteration, find the minimum weight edge, say E star, which is connecting from V star to U star, among all the edges V, U, such that V is in already seen vertices and U is in unseen vertices. So E star is nothing but an edge with minimum weight that connects from the seen vertices to the unseen vertices. Once finding such an edge, add U star to the set of visited vertices or seen vertices, as well as add the edge E star to the spanning tree. Repeat this particular process n minus 1 number of times, where n is the number of vertices in the graph. Finally, the minimum spanning tree is nothing but the set of edges given in ET. The efficiency of the Prim's algorithm depends on the data structures that is used to represent the graph as well as the priority queue. The priority queue is used to select the edges with the minimum weight. As we know, the efficiency depends on the data structures chosen for graph, and for the priority queue of the set V minus VT, whose vertex priorities are the distances to the nearest tree vertices. Suppose if you use weight matrix to represent the graph, and the priority queue is implemented using an unordered array, the total running time will be big theta of n square, where n is the total number of vertices. This is because we need to repeat n minus 1 number of times. At each iteration, the array implementing the priority queue is traversed to find and delete the edge with the minimum weight, and then to update the priorities of the remaining vertices. Altogether, the algorithm complexity will be big theta of n square, where n is the total number of vertices. We can implement the priority queue as a min heap also. Min heap is a data structure, is nothing but a complete binary tree in which every element is less than or equal to its children. You can observe that in the min heap, the deletion of the smallest element or insertion of a new element happens in order of log n operations. Suppose the graph is represented as an adjacency list, and min heap is used for the priority queue, then the running time of the Prim's algorithm will be order of total edges log total vertices. So why this particular linear complexity comes into picture? This is because the algorithm performs total vertices minus 1 number of deletions of the smallest element from the edge list, because altogether we need to add vertices minus 1 number of edges to form the spanning tree. At every time it makes total edges number of verifications. In addition to this, each of these operations, the priority queue to delete the smallest element, it uses log total vertices number of operations. So altogether, the running time of this implementation of the PRIMS algorithm is total vertices minus 1 plus total edges into big O of log total vertices. So as the total vertices minus 1 is less than total edges, the whole expression is get reduced to big O of total edges log total vertices.